you have any evidence that Russia cyber actors changed vote tallies in the state of Michigan?
No, I do not.
How about the state of Pennsylvania?
No, sir.
The state of Wisconsin?
No, sir.
State of Florida?
No, sir.
The state of North Carolina?
No, sir.
Well, that was the director of the NSA, Michael Rogers, during today's hearing, reminding us that despite the daily hysterics about Russia, there's no proof they actually changed the outcome of the election last fall. Mark Stein is an author and commentator, always a man with interesting thoughts. He says that Russia is fundamentally Western, and that means something. He joins us now from Burlington, Vermont, a fundamentally Western city. Mark, thanks a lot for coming on. So,
this is less Western than many Russian cities.
It is less Western. It's pretty, though. So, what is this about? I mean, I understand the political component to it. Of course, we live in Washington. I get what this is about, hurting the Trump people, fine. But there does seem to be something genuine at the core here. Democrats seem actually mad at Russia in a way that I can't remember them being. Why do you think they are?
Well, I think they're mad at Russia because they want to believe that they did not lose the election, that somebody stole it from them. And that's why what we saw today, frankly, was nuts. I mean, the Democrats, as you said, they've turned Putin into a Bond villain, the man with the spider's touch, as that congresswoman almost sang today. They're two sound bites from insisting that they're going to build a new Berlin Wall and get Russia to pay for it. This is going nowhere for them. It's a massive head fake. And if you did subscribe seriously to the theory that Putin was trying to mess with America, what do we have now? We have an interminable investigation that is designed to drag down the United States government. This investigation, this furor, is actually doing Putin's bidding more than having some cabinet secretary in his pocket would. So today's hearings were bizarre in a very particular way. And when someone like Comey says, you know, oh, Vladimir Putin absolutely hates Hillary Clinton, what business is that of a domestic law enforcement agency? Why the hell is the FBI wasting its time trying to figure out what Vladimir Putin thinks of some washed-up has-been presidential candidate?
And also, how would they know? And of course, that's fundamentally unknowable, and you shouldn't say you know things when you don't, especially in sworn testimony on Capitol Hill. So what should our posture toward Russia be? What should we think of Russia, those of us who are not caught up in that? I'm kind of agnostic. What should I think about Russia?
Well, I think Russia is fundamentally, once you strip away a century of communism, Russia is essentially the prodigal child of Western civilization. You know, it's Chekhov and Tchaikovsky and Pushkin and Rachmaninoff, and the idea that we need to turn it into an enemy simply because it has a flawed government, I think is idiotic. Mike Flynn, for example, I'm in favor of Flynn being gone, not because he has ties with the Russians, but because he was in the pay of the Turks. And I regard Erdogan as a far greater threat to Western civilization than Vladimir Putin is. And that conversation you are having at the top of the show, in which Democrats are demanding that we double down on sanctions, again, I think we ought to start thinking about this in a reasonable way. Crimea, I speak as a 19th century imperialist here, so Crimea and Balaclava and Sebastopol and the Charge of the Light Brigade are engraved in my soul, but I think Crimea is a legitimate sphere of Russian influence. And the idea that Democrats are suddenly prepared to launch World War III over Crimea is completely preposterous. Where were they on this 40 years ago?
Well, that's in a very different place. It's also a little weird to hear people who've lionized Hugo Chavez and Fidel Castro complain about a strongman. So quickly, Trump's position, he said it out loud, is that we share a common enemy in radical Islam with the Russian government, and we can make common cause to fight it. Is that a tenable plan?
I think so. Trump at his rally tonight was emphasizing America first. Make America great again. Putin wants to make Russia great again. And insofar as those objectives don't conflict, We should think strategically. Russia, frankly, has had a much better track record in Syria. They've kept their strong man in place. We've spent 15 years in a ramshackle Stone Age basket case like Afghanistan for 15 years, and we've got nothing to show for it. There's actually, Trump's right. We could learn from Putin in these parts of the world.
Nicely put. As always, Mark Stein, the best. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Tucker. Enjoyed it.